Hello, I'm Kirby Mohr. I'm an oil water separator engineer. I'm a registered professional engineer in the state of Texas, and I've been doing oil water separators for roughly 30 years. Today we're going to talk about Stokes' law and how they work for oil water separator applications. Basically, all oil water separators operate utilizing Stokes' law. They remove droplet form oil. The droplets rise to the plates according to Stokes' law and stick by van der Waals forces. These are very weak molecular level forces, so they don't stick very well. Basically, they just stick until a few more droplets come along and form a film, as shown on the photo here. And after they form a film, the film eventually slides up the underside of the plates by their buoyancy and comes to the surface. So this is Stokes' law here. The oil is present in a spectrum of droplet sizes from some very tiny ones to some quite large ones. And the separation of the oil in any kind of separator, be it an API separator or a coalescing plate separator, is governed by Stokes' law. And this is Stokes' law here. The VP, that's the rise velocity of the droplets, is equal to the gravitational constant times the difference between the specific gravity, the density of the particles, and the continuous phase. The continuous phase in this case is the water and the particles are the oil droplets, times the diameter of the droplet squared over 18 times the viscosity of the water. The density of the droplets, the viscosity of the continuous phase, which is the water, and that's dependent upon the operating temperature, and the average droplet size, which is the biggest single variable because it's a squared function. So Stokes' assumptions, Stokes, in generating that formula that I showed you earlier, assumed laminar flow both horizontally and vertically, so very, very slow and even flow, a consistent specific gravity, and in the case of oil droplets, that's pretty reasonable. Spherical particles, which again in the case of oil droplets is reasonable. The interfacial tension between the oil and the water keeps the particles in spheres. That's not true for solid particles, and you have to make allowance for that if you are doing the calculations. Stokes also assumed a consistent particle size. And we know that there's going to be a bunch of different droplet sizes. So if you want to determine the separation efficiency of a given separator, you have to do several droplet sizes. As I said, the droplets rise to meet the underside of the plates. As more droplets come along, they form a film. The film slides up the underside of the plates by their buoyancy, and it comes to the peaks of the plates. Large oil droplets then weep from plate to plate to plate and then to the surface. So with this kind of system, we're actually converting droplets less than 40 microns, smaller than what the human eye can see, into really large drops the size of a grape or perhaps the end of your thumb. So the advantages of coalescing oil using Stokes' law. It's a high efficiency and it's a predictable oil removal. Some types of separators use random packing, and they do remove oil to some extent, but it's not predictable. So you don't know whether you're going to get the performance you hope you're going to need. We can design for whatever the maximum effluent is allowed. The requirement in the United States is usually that it meet the rules of the Clean Water Act, and that's generally considered to be 15 milligrams per liter in the effluent, and that's certainly possible to do with coalescing plates. Coalescing plate type separators are much smaller than API separators because they don't have to have the large residence time that API separators have. And there's no channeling or dead spot problems because the oil is separated within the plates, within the media. If you have a large empty tank, you'll get a lot of channeling and a lot of dead spots that are not doing any good with the separation. So here are some typical plate modules. And there you can see the underside of the plates where the coalescing actually occurs, and the holes in the peaks of the plates where the oil weeps from peak to peak to peak and comes out after it has been coalesced into large droplets. Thanks for listening to Stokes Law for Oil Water Separator Applications. Please call us for design assistance on your project. I put my phone number here, which is 918-299-9290, and my email, which is Kirby@oilandwaterseparator.com.